The Photo Frames Photoshop add-on by Panos FX lets you create an incredible variety of photo frames, which you can use to show off your photos. Begin with loading the photo frames patterns, which are included in the files you downloaded. This is done differently in Photoshop CC than in Photoshop Elements or in older Photoshop versions. If you have Photoshop CC, select Window, Patterns, from the menu. Click the panel's menu button and select the option Import Patterns. Navigate to the product files, open the Patterns folder, and load the Patterns file. You have successfully loaded the photo frames patterns in Photoshop CC. If you have Photoshop Elements or an older Photoshop version, such as CS6, CS5, CS4, or CS3, load the Patterns file by selecting Edit, Preset Manager, from the menu. Select Patterns from the drop-down list. Click the Load button and load the Patterns file from your hard disk. Having loaded the Patterns file, you now need to load the Photo Frames Actions file in Photoshop. Select Window Actions from the menu. Click the panel's menu button and select Load Actions. Navigate to the product folders and load the Actions file in Photoshop. The actions of the photo frame set are organized in three large groups. To create a photo frame, you need to begin with running one of the actions in the first group. Then you can use, at any order, the actions in the other two groups to add and modify the frame pattern, the frame style, and the lens flare. Let's take a closer look at the actions in the first group. The first group contains 9 actions, which create frames of square, portrait, and landscape shape. For each shape, there are 3 actions that you can use. The first 2 actions create a photo frame with a matte board. The third action creates a photo frame without a mat. The words Rectangle Mode and Pixels Mode in the action names indicate the method used to create the mat and the frame. In Rectangle Mode, you define visually the areas of the mat and the frame by resizing a rectangle on your screen with your mouse. The Pixels Mode is more precise, but less intuitive. To define the mat and frame areas, the action asks you to enter their sizes in pixels instead of resizing a rectangle on your screen. Now that we have an idea of what these actions do, let's use them to create a frame. In this example, we will create a portrait frame with a matte board. Photoshop asks you to enter your preferred size for the frame photo. Enter the preferred size in pixels in the width and height fields and hit OK to confirm and move on. A rectangle shows up around the photo. It defines the area of the matte board. Hold down the Alt key on a PC keyboard or the Option key on a Mac and drag a corner handle to resize proportionally the rectangle that defines the matte board area. To resize non-proportionally, hold down Shift and Alt or Shift and Option and drag a corner inwards or outwards. When you finish, double-click to confirm and move on to the next step. A new rectangle shows up around the matte board. It lets you define the area of the frame. Again, hold down Alt or Option and drag a corner handle to resize the rectangle. When you finish, double-click to confirm. Photoshop created the photo, the mat board, and the frame. You can pick a custom color for the mat board. You can change it again later. The last step lets you blur the shadow that is cast by the frame. Move the Gaussian blur and hit OK to confirm. Photoshop users can change the Gaussian blur filter settings again later, since this is a smart filter. The frame has been created. We'll now use the actions in the second and the third group to improve its looks. Let's use the action which adds a pattern to the frame. The pattern picker shows up. Pick a pattern and observe the change to the look of the frame. You can change the other settings, such as the angle or the scale. You can still change the pattern. Go to the Layers panel and double-click the thumbnail of the respective layer. Scroll up to the top of the Layers panel. You can use the Levels adjustment layer to further adjust the look of the frame. The Add a Second Pattern action does what its name indicates. It lets you add a second pattern, which is blended with the first one. This way you can create elegant composite frame patterns. You can fine-tune the result by changing the opacity of the pattern layer. In the Actions panel, you'll also find a Hue Saturation Adjustment layer. It lets you modify the hue of the frame. This adjustment layer is deactivated by default. Click its eyeball icon to activate it. Double-click its thumbnail and adjust the settings to your liking. The next action lets you add a lens flare effect. Resize and reposition the layer. When you finish, double-click to confirm. Occasionally, you'll need to reposition the lens flare, especially after you add the photo to the frame. The next action helps you with this. Now, let's find out how to add a custom photo to our frame. If you have Photoshop, select the smart layer named Photo and double-click its thumbnail to edit its contents. Select File, Place from the menu. Load a photo and place it over the background. If necessary, resize it proportionally by holding down the Alt key or the Option key and dragging a corner handle. Double-click to confirm. Close the file and save your changes to update the frame. If you have Photoshop Elements, select the layer named File, Place to insert photo. Select File, Place from the menu. Load a photo from your hard disk. Resize it proportionally and double-click to confirm. As was mentioned earlier, after you insert a photo, you may want to reposition the lens flare using the respective action. The last group contains the various styling actions. You can run them at any order and change dramatically the style of the frame. Don't forget to use the Levels Adjustment layer to adjust the looks of the frame. To revert back to the original style, run the default styling action. Thank you very much for watching.